Happy New Year, my Saddleback family. It's going to be a great year. I love New Year's. Why is it going to be great? Because His mercies are new every morning. Great is His faithfulness. Can I get an amen? I want to talk to you in this short devotion about finding your purpose through your pain. It's such an important subject, and it's actually something I have a little experience with. C.S. Lewis, any other C.S. Lewis fans? Author of The Problem of Pain, penned these famous words. Pain insists upon being attended to. God whispers to us in our pleasures, speaks in our conscience, but shouts in our pain. It's His megaphone to rouse a deaf world. When we experience pain, we become keenly aware of God's character. When our self-sufficiency is peeled away, we then just see how weak and vulnerable that we really are. The Apostle Paul in 2 Corinthians 1:3-4 said these words, "Praise be to the Father and God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God." I'd like to share with you two truths about God's unbelievable character. Number one, He's called the Father of Compassion, which means He has a deep feeling about your pain and your misfortune. And the good news is He has a capacity to help you out. Second, He's called the God of all comfort. When our hearts are broken, when we are overwhelmed with pain and grief, God's comfort becomes a healing ointment to our souls. We are comforted by His everlasting love, His abiding presence. The psalmist said in Psalm 34:18, "The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and He saves those who are crushed in spirit." And we're comforted by His amazing grace. Here's the point. God comforts us for a specific reason. Paul said in verse 4, "So that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God." God wants us to do something in response to the comfort He's given us, and He expects us to use our pain to help others. Now, think of the biggest trial or the most painful situation you've ever experienced in your life. Think about that just for a moment. God doesn't want you to waste your hurt. He wants to redeem your suffering. By far, the biggest hurt in my life was the death of my youngest daughter, Jackie, who died from a brain tumor when she was just 5 years old. Nearly every day, I talk to somebody about loss and grief and my role as a care pastor at Saddleback. I didn't choose this ministry, it chose me. But I love what I do. I love it. I love this ministry. I get to come alongside people in their darkest hour and bring comfort and hope. My mess has become my ministry. My pain has become my purpose. What pain in your life can you help somebody else through? An interesting reality of suffering is that our personal pain also speaks to those around us. Our pain becomes God's megaphone to a hurting and watching world. The world gravitates to a young girl who has hope in the midst of her own terminal cancer diagnosis, as she visits other kids who have cancer in the hospital and gives out joy jars that she created. Eric Ries, her father, started NEGU, Never Ever Give Up, to honor his daughter, 12-year-old Jessie Ries, who died of cancer. Bystanders were astonished over a mom named Candy Leitner, who endured the death of her 13-year-old daughter, Carrie, who was hit by a drunk driver while walking. And yet Candy turned around to help others avoid such pain by starting MAD, Mothers Against Drunk Drivers. Mental health sufferers were inspired and encouraged by our own beloved Kate Warren, who out of her own pain over the loss of her son, Matthew, who suffered himself from mental health issues and who died from suicide, started a mental health community at Saddleback called Hope for Mental Health. So I thought, we also need a community for those who grieve. The reality is, grief never dies because love never dies. It's ongoing. So in an effort to create space for the bereaved at Saddleback and the surrounding community, and to honor my daughter, Jackie, I recently started our Hope for Grief community. I'm so excited about this new ministry that we've started. Our pain gives us a platform. The question becomes then, what am I saying to the world in the midst of my pain? As I trust God, even in my heartache, I let my life speak of a hope that extends beyond this world. When the megaphone of pain sounds in our lives and in the lives of our unbelieving friends, please let's not respond with a fake facade like we got it all together, or wallow in our own self-pity. If unbelievers who are experiencing their own pain are going to seek out a Christ follower for help, it will not be because we appear to live lives that are free from trials, but because we are honest about our own pain and our own suffering. May we not attempt to have an answer for every question, since we know that only God knows certain things. But let's affirm that even in the mystery of his purposes, we know the security of his love, and we will seek to introduce others to a God who entered into our sufferings through his son, Jesus Christ. Jesus' suffering on the cross on our behalf reveals God's great love for us. His pain truly was our gain. I pray that you find your purpose through your pain. And as pain shouts to a hurting world, may our lives always sing of the fact that God is good, even when our circumstances are not. Happy New Year, my Saddleback family. I love you guys.